Hey developers, I hope you're doing good. So if you have watched my last video about installing Tailwind CSS in a React application, I'm pretty sure it's working fine in your React application. But if it's not working in your React application, let's go step by step and see what's happening. So I have set up a React application and have installed Tailwind CSS in it, but it's not working. So let's go to the code. So the very first thing that you have to do is to check the package.json and see if Tailwind CSS, Post CSS and Auto Prefixer has been installed. So as you can see, I have Tailwind CSS, I have Auto Prefixer and I also have Post CSS. So the three dependencies are already installed. So after you have verified that all the dependencies are installed, the next step is to check if you have tailwind.config.js and postcss.config.js as it has been mentioned in the documentation. So as you can see, after installing Tailwind CSS, we have to create tailwind.config.js and postcss.config.js. So let's go to the code and let's verify if we have tailwind.config.js and postcss.config.js. So as you can see, I don't have that file. So let's go back to documentation and let's see how we can generate the files. So all you have to do is to copy this command and you have to go to the terminal and run this command. So let me close the project and let's generate those files. So just run this command. So after that command has been executed, you will see created Tailwind CSS config file and created post CSS config file. So let's go back to our code and let's see if we have tailwind.config.js and also we have postcss.config.js. So now we have both of these files. So let's try adding classes and let's see if those classes are working. So let me add class name text center and let me run that project. Now I can go to HTTP localhost 5173 port. So as you can see, Tailwind CSS is still not working. So in the third step, we have to check if we have correct configuration for Tailwind CSS. So let's go back to code and let's go back to tailwind.config.js. So as you can see, the content is empty for me. So I have to tell Tailwind CSS where to scan for the files. So let's go back to documentation and let's copy this content array and then paste in our tailwind.config.js. So let me paste the content. So now I have index.html source and all the file extensions to scan for. So this is the third step. And now if I go back to my project, I can see the Tailwind CSS is still not working. So in the fourth step, you have to verify if you have added Tailwind CSS directives or not. So let's go back to documentation and it says that you have to add Tailwind CSS directives. So let's copy these directives and let's go back to our code. So you have to go to index.css. As you can see, my index.css is empty. So I have to add those Tailwind CSS directives. So now if I paste those directives and I save this file and let me go back to my browser. As you can see, Tailwind CSS is now working for me and it has centered this content. So in the fifth step, if it is not working for you, then go back to your code and you have to verify the classes that you are using are valid Tailwind CSS classes. So let's say I add background green 500 and let's add text dash bold. So it will not work. As you can see, the classes are not working because these two classes are not valid Tailwind CSS classes. So I have to find the correct class, which is bg green 500, and it's not text bold, it's font bold. So as you can see, now it's working fine and I have green background with the bold text in my browser. I'm sure if you follow all this stuff and set up everything correctly, your Tailwind CSS in a React application will be working fine. If it's still not working, just let me know in the comments. And if any step has fixed your issue, just let me know what you were missing. So if you want to learn more about Tailwind CSS and some of the tips I have shared, just watch my this video. See you in that video.